It's Monday. I usually call my Mondays. Wait, I forgot my earrings again. Anyway, usually Mondays are money-making Mondays for me, but lately, since not everybody's going to go out and money-make, it's just a regular Monday. If you ask me what happened over the weekend in my world, absolutely nothing. But I clearly see y'all is still entertaining yourself during these very hard quarantine times. TVs and radio stations have all reinvented themselves for online trafficking. I want to talk about that in a bit, but before we even get into anything, my name is Tina Fierce One and the show is Scoop and Scoop. Let's get it. Hey, woo child, yesterday, now I know, usually whenever I do a story about People Power or Bobby Wine, all of y'all easily get very mad. And it's perfectly fine for all of you to get mad, and it is perfectly fine for me to have my own opinions about him, because, well, my opinion is also valid because it's my life, it is what I want to think about at that moment, and at the end of the day, we are all entitled to our opinion. So, usually when I give you my opinion, y'all go and run with it and say it's biased. I even remember when I did the story last week about Ashbag Kato and him receiving money from Kai Nerugaba's camp, and in the YouTube comment section, I saw a bunch of you dimwits flaring up for entirely no reason. Like, you didn't even try to understand the argument here. The argument wasn't about who is politicking, who is politricking, who is trying to play us. The argument was one. Enjala temanyi politics na enemuawara. Anywho, yesterday, I saw perfection. Yesterday, I honestly took a minute out and was thankful for perfection. COVID-19, thank you. Because finally, after COVID-19 is when we are going to open up our minds. Because after the success of Bobby Wine's online concert last night, over 27,000 viewers, that love was crazy. After that success, it made me beg the question, if only someone had been smart from the jump and let Bobby Wine do online concerts, from all the time that they were tear gassing him, from all the time that the step was being paired, you know, brutally unfair to him, according to, you know, what they're saying, and not just according to, I saw it, I'm Ugandan, I live in the same country. I wish he had thought about this genius plan. My goodness, he would be unstoppable. John Wan, great, this thing was so nice. Don Wanyama Yesu Zemangere. He was watching live, daddy, live. I think people in Statehouse were like, now we cannot stop this concert. This concert is happening. But it was nice. I want to thank the team that did this brother's lighting. I want to thank the team that did this brother's acoustic and sound. I want to thank all the heads. Let's be honest. I give credit where it's due. Bobby Wine's concert last night, online, his quarantine concert. I ain't saying nothing bad about that concert. Regardless of the glitches, that is us. It is Africa. Our internet is not that good, but damn! This boy was meant to be an entertainer. If you ask me, I feel Bobby Wine has a bigger chance speaking for the masses and being a mover and shaker, just being himself, without even needing the politics. But hey, that's my opinion. That's my opinion, because as an entertainer, for you to garner that much online support in the shortest time possible, that is gold. It's gold, which makes me again, but before I can kubuza that bibuzo, let's take a minute and say thank you, Chagulan, for giving us an online concert that was worth our time. You did. He honestly did, apart from the one that I did last time that I talked about, that was A-Pass, Wyke Bender, Martha K, and DJ Edman. This, for me, ranked two. He did. But then again, now that I have finished Okubuze, I want to understand. Jonah, mbulira kati online concerts, bezinafuke cha bulijo. How are they going to earn from it? Is it number of subscribers that jump onto your YouTube channel whenever you perform? Because when the subscriber number goes up, you get a PayPal account and YouTube can pay you. So are they do? That's the way? Because if I do a YouTube channel, it makes more sense. So when I do a live, so wait, were they live streaming it on YouTube or was it being like, because I watched it on Facebook, all platforms. Yeah, that's a good way. That's definitely a good way. So kati chogamba jona. Zino concert is also going to come as a way. Tebagenda kuliyako. Mpozi bana bana agamba nze nsadeyo donation, donation eh? Why you still? It's a good way to go, especially when it comes to the virtual world. It's now taken over. I was honestly floored. I loved the lighting. I loved the fact that he sang his heart out. And let me tell you something funny. Every time Bobby Wine puts down or puts off the Politrix court and puts on the entertainer court, I am so happy. So happy because he is an entertainer. He is. Anyway, that was a success. I'm not going to say anything more about it. I'm not. This one is just a by the way. Congratulations are in order for my boy. Yes, DJ Aluda and the love of his life, Paris. They had a scientific wedding over the weekend. I saw the photos and I was like, he did this. I was so happy. If there's a couple that I wish nothing but beautiful things, it has to be this couple. They have gone through it all together. They have stuck by each other and it's so beautiful because I witnessed this love blossom many, many years ago. So yeah, congratulations are in order for DJ Aluda. At least he's making the DJ Association not look like dogs. He finally got hitched, posted it up on Instagram and he was like, I'm taken and I'm happily married. I was like, you go, brother. You go. You know how DJs just don't want to get married? How many DJs do you know that are married? How many? Who? Only him. Wait. What about Selector J? He looks like he should be married. But even the older DJs. Yeah, but even the older DJs never used to be. Took them a while to be, you know? Put down a bit. DJs never get married. Come to think about it. Very few DJs get married. Shiru. You think Siri is going to get married now? Who? Hey! I'm going to get married. What's your brother? DJ Sise. DJ Ape-Man. LL. Yeah, I'm going to get married. The Nimrod. Wait, is Nimrod a DJ? Ali Breezy. Oh, come on. Those guys are all not looking like marriage is going to be calling anytime soon. They are married to their mixed turntables and all of that. But hey, like I said, man, let's support the brother and sister. They did something good. They made it official, you know? Congratulations, DJ Aluda and Paris. Anna Paris, actually. Slick Stewart and Roger getting married. To who? And you know, there's still that bias, like the world has opened up to different jobs being real jobs, right? But do you know, for some reason, when you take a DJ home, your parents may know what he does, but they'll still be like, he's a what? DJ. Anyway, that's enough drama with those guys too. Never be more circle. Stop sleeping with all the buzz that you go to play in. I'll get you one main squeeze and consider the fact. Hey, Gwe, you go to one bar that a DJ plays at and he has slept with the entire first row dancing to his music. Hey, check out. First, wait. How far with what's happening in Tanzania? The last time I checked on the entertainment scene, there was so much back and forth between Rayvanny, Diamond Platnumz. I read something that Rayvanny actually had to buy out his contract with Wasafi Records and it wasn't something cheap. It was a lot of money and he had to actually sell off one of his houses. I was like, yo, what? Now, this is how you know that the Tanzanian music industry, it was. So I know. Wabo yagala kuva ku brand. Yeah, mwevumira ku social media, buli muna abikula secrets za munne company nebikula nayo nobikula ne mwevuma. Before you know it, I am an independent artist. But yo, Think about it. If we were taken, if we were taking our music industry or the entertainment industry that seriously, it would be a colossal industry. We'd actually be able to say that we contribute about, you know, 1 billion a year for the country. Wasafi Records. But whoever thought, where would you live? I'm going to go to the Diamond Platinum. Entertainment scene, you know, every time I'm trying to understand it, it is hapo onaona mindanganya. I'm like, hey, calm down. I just want the rugambo and ogenda ku entertainment scene ya Tanzania. Ngononya yo rugambo nebi kusobera. When you try to Google Translate, hey, Tanzania Kiswahili doesn't make sense on Google Translate, it does not, but hey. I think I'm going to branch into them too because they seem to be interesting. Apart, they're like the biggest exporters of sleigh queens and whores. So, you know, that has to be something we can get into. It's a Monday. What do you expect me to talk about? The TV argument and the 50k and that we need more money. We are underpaid. It's still going on. Now let us pass on to jump on it was Jay Kazora, and I saw he made a couple of valid, you know, suggestions here and there. Very many that I disagreed with too. And then I still saw this tiny little thing again still coming hard. Before I know, she was on late night television on Friday night. Was it Friday night or Saturday? But then again, she came in as a host, and then I jump on Twitter, and then I just want to see the public's reaction, and all of them are like, but wait, she shows up, like she contradicts herself just like her daddy, and everyone wanted me to say something. Yo, I'm not going to say nothing. I'm done. My issue here is, I know you have all seen the content that is on national television at the moment. These are unprecedented times, which means we're going to do some very unprecedented things, right? But I'm looking at all these TV stations, and my question is, what is the longevity of whatever it is that you're doing? So I'm seeing all these dance parties on the night because it's lockdown and all of that, people can't go out. So it's a party, yeah? What is their sustainability? Because before another one jumps out of the woodworks and says they were being underpaid or not valued, we need to think in on this. I mean, what is the longevity? Because I see every TV station rolling out a new plan. I see every radio station rolling out a new plan. I see different TV stations making particular brands, their brand names and all of that. But then what happens when the dust finally settles down, right? And life goes back to normal. Then what? You think you're Jonathan Nachavuzako? For now, but we're not always going to be in lockdown. Then someone is going to be like, Tina, what's your problem? Let the TV, other TVs think about what they'll do. My problem is one, I am part of this TV society. Whenever we mess up as a collective. When they say we earn 50k, we earn it as a collective. You get. So I'm just trying to... The best of luck, though. May the best man win, don't you think? Because it's going to be fun to look at the trajectory of the TV curve once people get out of lockdown. Because I don't have a feeling, it's the truth. People have been sitting at home for way too long. As soon as they are let out... You know what? I think my mind is the problem, because trajectory again, they took it at a point that when people are left to go out again, they're going to want to work times three just to, you know, so now ask yourself as a TV station, as a radio station, what is your longevity? What is your sustainability? Or are you going to go back to the drawing board and you're like, that programming was for quarantine? Let us now reprogram for regular life again. So reprogramming for regular life again, are you going to take us back to the old settings? Because now we have tested freedom. We have tested national TV where girls can come on TV butt naked and twerk and get drunk and we're still like, woo-wee-woo. So are we going to get our morals back? After, so what direction is can't be tested, Jacqueline, that TV. Oh, and by the way, I know it's a bit late to say this. I wanted to take a minute out to wish every mother out there a belated Happy Mother's Day. I mean, I know how that ish takes me out. Like, if there is no holiday, to be honest, I think I just breeze through most holidays, but Mother's Day is one holiday. It's a holiday that is very, very special to me because it means a lot. Being a mom, it means a lot. So I just want to take a minute from the team, from us to you, you know. Happy belated Mother's Day to all of you who are there, even the bitter ones on Fresh Peaches. We see you. Even the married ones who are alone and mothering alone in their marriages. We see you. We got nothing but love. Nothing but love. That's been my Monday. Nothing much really has gone down. I saw Abitex saying something about Mama Finabaneva Navantubatulekemunabo, boredom and wanting the likes and the follows. He was there telling Mama Fina he's the right woman, right man for her. Owning and sitting and your Kazakula Kobutuz no Zikida. Anywho, baby, I do hope this week is a little bit more eventful in a good way. We are all seated here waiting for when they will lift a ban. Now, we went 2 weeks before we were put back in lockdown, 2 weeks without a registered COVID case, and I was like, we have beaten it. And now every day there's a new truck driver, every day. And when I say every day, teru ziba luke nokuziba bwelutinga Ministry of Health atekayo alert, another COVID driver, another. Does the government know that this is how you're going to start making people get ideas? Because we are sitting at home trying to keep ourselves safe. We're social distancing, we've quit work, we're trying to stay alive, which means we're trying to look out for our country. But you can't tell me that as I am doing all of that. Now I tell you, you're just bringing unexported illness into the country. I wish my president can address certain things when he comes back to talk. Not coming back and then he asks for IAOB and then he tells us where he stopped yesterday. No, Mr. President, as a Ugandan, I want to know why you are still letting these people in without them being tested. And as a human being, I want to understand why Tanzania or Kenya or any of these places where these truck drivers are coming from does not want to test them before. And then again, I want to ask why my government cannot see to it that if they get to the border, they disinfect the whole car, switch up drivers, the one that is there, switch up drivers and let another relay, like a relay driver, come through and bring the goods where they're supposed to be. So in that way, we do not have to register cases in the country. This COVID thing is already too confusing because for me, when they say COVID cases, I expect the ones that have just been found. But they read COVID cases in a funny way, and it's alarming. Because now we are 100 and what? So why are we still counting the ones that are healed? Actually, 116. While Ugandans are staying home. We're staying home. Come on. Dr. Ruth Acheng, I know you are the hero in here in this whole movie, but yo, mtubale mama gezi, people want to get back to their real lives. Really? Really? And I have not yet heard another country that goes like, Ugandan truck drivers are the ones coming positive. I have not, which means my community could be somewhat safe, we're not sure. And then what is this thing I had that actually all the truck drivers are sleeping somewhere around Nambole and the people in Nambole are getting scared? I have many questions, but hey, people, all I can say is mwefeko, be there for yourself, you know? Wash your hands, social distance. This too shall come to a pass and to an end, but it's really, really frustrating. Very. On that note, That's how my Monday has been. It has been a recap of what happened pretty much over the weekend. At TinaFears1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop under TinaFears1. Not forgetting on Instagram, that's at TinaFears1 with an H. And on Snapchat, it's TinaFears1. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. I hope it has better stories. And let's make a bet, Jonah. Oh, by the way, Jonah will be with us for the next 2 weeks. He's the new guy. Jonah, you know him twale vidi. Jenta deo, mani mweno karantine, mtuale vidi minji kumutua aninge mtuale itan. Sicho, and ako say mtuale vidi mbu, we are going to register 5 more cases from truck drivers. Ota deo meka? A vidi? Chiwe ide. Katuvene wano. I'm out. Wash your hands. Stay home. Stay safe. Stay sane. I'm out. Peace.